Hello, hello, hello. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be. Welcome back to my channel, my loverlies. If you've never been here before, thank you so much for clicking on my video. I am so happy you found me. I do so hope that you will like and subscribe before you leave. Become part of the Mama family. Mama's got your back, at least when makeup's concerned, and definitely when that makeup is cheap. Today is going to be just a super casual chatty get ready with me. I haven't filmed a video like this in a hot minute, and there's lots going on in my life at the moment, so I figured now was the perfect time to do it. We've got lots to talk about. Also, I am playing with the new Glam Light Rick and Morty palette. Rick and Morty is my very favorite adult cartoon. Absolutely fantastic. Don't necessarily agree, definitely don't agree with the creator of this. If you know, you know. If you don't, look it up. Really not a nice person, but I'm so in love with the actual cartoon that I couldn't help myself. I had to get it. So this is it's a little bit higher up on the affordable scale, or on the affordable price range. It's a $36 palette. So it definitely, it's not like undoable, like it's doable, but it kind of hurts a little bit to do it, you know, to like to pay that price for it. But when it comes to Glam Light, their formulations are just so fantastic. I just absolutely cannot. Glam Light is the only brand that I stock their new releases. I stock every single new release because just something about the brand, the way that they do the packaging, the way that they execute things, the color stories, the formula, everything comes together in a perfect storm of just take my money. I just throw my money at them and they take it with a big old smile on their face. I don't regret this purchase at all whatsoever though. It is so fantastic. So this is what the actual palette looks like. It is absolutely perfect. I love it. And again, really beautiful, heavy, like heavy duty, like quality kind of cardboard packaging. I adore the Glam Light packaging. So, so pretty. You open it up and y'all, it is the most stunning, most bright, most electric kind of rainbow color story. This is 100% Rick and Morty. Like Rick and Morty, if you've ever watched it, is kind of like it's almost like a super trippy and like Technicolor, things like that. This is so perfect. I adore this. And you guys know I am a sucker for a big, bold, bright, beautiful palette like this. So I was all in. Y'all, the same great matte and shimmer formulas that I have come to know and obsess over from Glam Light. Absolutely fantastic. I'm not going to go too much into it because I am going to do a comparison for next week's New Makeup Monday. I do think that there are a couple of palettes, both from Glam Light and other brands, that are very, very similar to this palette. So you might not necessarily need to go pick this one up. We're going to do comparisons, things like that. So be on the lookout for next week's New Makeup Monday. Guys, a special welcome if you are new here. Thank you so much for clicking on my video. I am so, so very happy that you are here. Guys, if you are enjoying the content, make sure you give this video a big old thumbs up. Make sure that you are subscribed and make sure that you click the little notification bell. Turn on all your notifications so that way next time I upload, you can come right back here and we can hang out together again. So jumping right into the chatty part of today's chatty get ready with me, I'm really getting ready to go absolutely nowhere. I will sit here and do my makeup and have nowhere to go. I am a stay-at-home mom and literally have no life outside of my home, which, yeah, we're not going to get into that, but I have no life. I never leave my house. So a lot of times I sit here and I do my makeup and I literally just sit here and stare at myself because I have, what am I going to do? Where am I going to wear it to? I will sit here and I'll do a full face of makeup, like a big giant rainbow eye, just to go get groceries at the grocery store, to go check the post office box, because really, what else do I have to do? But honestly, I just feel better. Makeup makes me happy. It genuinely makes me happy. I enjoy sitting here playing with my makeup. I enjoy sitting here just kind of testing out formulas and trying out new color combinations, things like that. It really does just bring me joy. And I am a firm believer in the fact that if you look good, you feel good. So if it's going to help enhance my mood, even the slightest degree, I'm definitely going to go for it. Y'all, I would walk around my house in a ball gown and a tiara if I thought it would make a difference. Like I'm just that kind of person. Speaking of really pretty dresses, I went to Walmart the other day and for $8, I found some of the most adorable like summer dresses. I am such a summer dress lover. I'm also very much a plus size lady. I wear a size 26, if that helps at all. But I am a big, big lover of a good summer dress. It's both flattering and it's pretty. It elevates your look, but it's easy to wear and it's comfortable. I love a pretty dress, and I found a bunch of them at Walmart for $8 a piece. And if you are plus size at all, you will know that oftentimes plus size clothing is so freaking expensive. I honestly don't think it's very fair, because oftentimes plus size clothing is so much more expensive. Like if you go, you can go to the Mrs. section and pick up a dress, and then go to the plus size section and pick up almost the same exact dress, and the plus size version is going to be at least $10 more expensive. And that irritates me so, so much. And I know that they have to use more fabric for the plus size dresses, things like that. But a $10 price difference, I just think is completely and totally ridiculous. So, needless to say, I don't often pick up new clothing unless there is some kind of sale going on. But when I saw those dresses on sale at Walmart, I jumped for joy. I was so, so ecstatic. Also, I went to the makeup section and saw so many of the new releases at my Walmart. And usually the new releases don't come to my Walmart for months after they've been released. And by that point, they're not even like relevant anymore. But there were a ton of the new ones there, so I picked up as much as I could. So the next couple weeks worth of New Makeup Mondays are going to be full of fantastic new releases from the drugstore. I absolutely cannot wait. And that also kind of leads me in to my next topic of discussion, which is next month is going to be a no-buy month for me. I am not spending a freaking dime on anything, whether it is makeup, whether it be nothing personal. If I need to get, you know, like laundry soap and dish detergent, things like that, but like anything extra, I'm not spending a freaking dime. I am buying no makeup next month. I was going through, I keep a log of literally every single thing that I purchase for my channel. I do that both for tax reasons and to try to kind of keep myself in check just a little bit, because I am what you would call a little bit of a shopaholic, and it can get very, very, it is very, very easy for me to just go completely and totally overboard and not realize how much money I'm actually spending on makeup. So I went through my notebook and saw how much money I have spent on makeup thus far this year. We're only a little bit more than halfway through the year, and I've spent nearly my entire year's budget. So we're not going to be buying any makeup at all in the month of July. I'm actually really excited about that. That's going to give me a chance to really go through my collection and really like kind of rediscover things that I fell in love with, and re-fall in love with already existing things in my collection. So again, I'm super, super excited about that. It's going to be nothing but a good thing. Also, is going to save me quite a bit of money. And the reason that I need that to happen right now is because, I'm so excited. We're going on vacation. We're going on vacation. It almost didn't happen. It wasn't going to happen. We didn't think that we could swing it this year. We haven't been on vacation in, I want to say, at least 4 years at this point. And it's just because, you know, COVID hit, and then we just kind of tried to regain our footing. We tried to kind of build back up our savings after COVID, and it's just scary. It's scary just to spend the money. It's scary to like kind of take that leap and leave your home and leave your animals. You know, we are dog lovers. We have dogs, like dogs abound. Like we have a whole pack of animals, and it's always just kind of scary to leave your home base and things like that, and be away for any amount of time. So we kept putting it off and putting it off and putting it off. And this year, my husband and I, we just were talking about it continuously. And we would tell ourselves that, yeah, we're just going to go. We're just going to do it. We're just going to go for it. And then I wouldn't book anything. I would look up, I'd go to TripAdvisor and Expedia, things like that, Kayak, whatever. I would go look at really gorgeous. The first thought was we really wanted to go down to Florida. Our favorite spot to go on vacation is Fort Myers. We love the Gulf of Mexico. We love the Keys. We just love being down there. The weather, the people, the animals, the wildlife, it's stunning down there. But it's hard, because not only do you have to worry about hotels, which are ridiculously expensive, you have to worry about food, which is so much more expensive down there because it's on the island. You have to worry about transportation. You have to worry about gas. You have to worry about money to eat out, things like that. It just is, it's such a big deal and it's such an undertaking that it just causes so much anxiety for me. And I just told myself, and my husband and I were talking, we just couldn't do that this year. First of all, we just don't have the money for it. And second of all, we just really don't want to go that far from home, right? It's like, it takes us almost an entire 24 hours to get there. So it's kind of a ridiculous undertaking, not feasible at the moment. So then we thought, well, okay, well, let's just go to Myrtle Beach, right? Because Myrtle Beach is in South Carolina. It is a little bit of a drive, but not quite as far as the Keys. And, you know, we've never been. We thought it might be really fun to take Sean for the first time. And then we got to looking at prices for hotels and things like that in the Myrtle Beach area. And y'all, it's just expensive, just as expensive to go to Myrtle Beach as it is to go to the Keys. Apparently, Myrtle Beach is an incredibly popular beach destination, which, you know, kind of makes sense because it's, you know, everybody knows about Myrtle Beach. But my husband and I had never been, and we just kind of assumed it would be a little bit more affordable to go to Myrtle Beach than it would be to go anywhere else. Well, we indeed were very, very wrong about that. So we were like, eh, maybe not. So then we just kind of put everything on hold, put it on the back burner. And school is very quickly approaching, and you know, summer's almost over. There's only maybe about a month left before the kid, you know, our son has to go back to school and things like that. And we were just like, I was just kind of thinking, and then my husband and I was like, well, what means, like, a vacation doesn't have to be just one thing. Like, in my mind, vacation means the beach, right? It's always how it's been. Vacation means we're going to the sea, right? And you have to kind of break those stigmas in your own brain and like be like, no, a vacation can be whatever we want a vacation to be. So we got to thinking, and we definitely decided that we wanted to go somewhere that was definitely more affordable, and we wanted to go somewhere that was a lot closer. We don't want to have to be in the car for 24 hours just to get to our destination. We just want to be able to get there and relax and enjoy our time, you know, without having to be miserable in the car for absolutely forever. So then we kind of came across an ad for, you know, we love Gatlinburg. We go to Gatlinburg and Sevierville all the time. So we were like, okay, well, you know, maybe we can find something to do here. And really the only thing we want is a nice hotel room that's got a pool, and we just kind of want to get away from here for a few days. So after searching extensively on all of the sites and things like that, we finally found something that we were really, really happy with and excited about. And still, I really hesitated to pull the trigger. I was like, oh, I don't know. You know, and even though it is much more affordable than anything at Myrtle Beach or anything in Florida, it's still a good chunk of change. And especially with how, especially with how uncertain the economy is at the moment, I was just like, oh, you know, it kind of hurts to spend that much money. There's always that like modicum of doubt, like, should I do this? Is this the right decision to make? And, you know, is this a responsible decision to make? Things like that. But at some point you just kind of have to pull the trigger. So I just pulled the trigger. I was like, okay, we're just gonna do it. We're just gonna go do it. So I booked it. I pushed you know, reserve, whatever, and then I pushed pay, and I was like, oh, my heart instantly dropped to my hiney. I was like, oh, I can't believe I just spent that much money. But after that, after it was done, it was also like an instant kind of relief almost as well, because I was like, oh, it's done, you know, now we don't have a choice, because it's non-refundable, of course. So now we don't have a choice, now we have to go. And it kind of takes the it takes the indecision away, because now you don't have a choice, you have to go. So I'm freaking stoked. I'm super, super excited. We'll be leaving and spending a couple days just getting away from everyone and everything, and I absolutely cannot wait. And it's nothing special or fancy, but it is exactly what we need, exactly what my family needs at this point in time. We just need to be able to go and kind of have just a little bit of together time. We just need to be able to go and take a break. And you know, I understand that I am my family and I are in an incredibly blessed position that we are able to go at all, because I know there are so many people out there who aren't able to take a vacation. And please don't think that I'm bragging at all, because it hurt to do it. But sometimes you just got to do what you got to do. And we are just so, we just need to get out of here. Also, I really want to reconnect with my husband. Life gets in the way. And my husband and I have been together for like 14 years at this point. Our 14 year anniversary is coming up very, very shortly. And, you know, I feel like we're kind of hitting that 14 year slump where we're almost starting to feel a little bit more like roommates than we are lovers. And I just kind of want to rekindle things with my husband a little bit. I want to, you know, recapture the spark. And the best freaking way to do that is by getting away from the ordinary, getting away from the everyday. And so we're just gonna go for it. I'm super, super excited. I can't wait. It won't affect my filming schedule at all. I already will make sure that I have everything that I need to pre-film and things like that done already. So you guys will still get your 3 videos from me this week. But I also am super excited because I want to try and vlog a little bit. I have done a couple of vlogs when we've done just kind of short day trips in the past. And the vlogs have always gone over really, really well. So I'm excited to do some more vlogs. Plus, the drive over there is always so freaking pretty. Last time we went, we saw elk on our way back, which elk are so majestic. If you've never seen an elk, it's pretty much just a gigantic deer, but they make the weirdest freaking noises, but they're huge. And we have to go through a forest reserve on our way to Gatlinburg. And so they're just all over the place, and they're basically right on the side of the road because it literally cuts through a forest. So you basically, if you wanted to put your hand out and touch them, you could. You're not supposed to do that, so don't do that. But if you wanted to put your hand out the window, you could literally touch them. So definitely go check my reels. It's on my page, and I don't think it's on YouTube, but it's definitely over on Instagram and Facebook if you want to go take a look at it. TikTok as well. But it was so, so beautiful. So I'm hoping we see some elk again. Also, I really want to go eat at Mellow Mushroom. If you've never tried Mellow Mushroom, it is, it is so, so good. It's one of my very, very favorite pizza places on the entire planet. They have like this pretzel crust pizza. And they have really good drinks as well. I'm not a drinker. I do not drink. I'm going to say literally the only time that I imbibe any kind of alcohol is when I'm on vacation. But y'all, I cut loose. I let loose and fancy free when I'm on vacation, because that's what it's there for. So I'm actually really excited to have a margarita. I would like to have a couple of mixed drinks and just kind of relax and let loose, let go for a little bit. I'm super, super excited. So in that same kind of vein, we need to go to Walmart tomorrow, which means we're going to Walmart twice this week, which is absolutely unheard of for us. So we're going to Walmart tomorrow to go pick up some snacks, things like that, because again, it's going to be super expensive. But I want to go get breakfast stuff because I made sure to get like a kitchenette. So we have a little refrigerator and a microwave, stuff like that. So I want to make sure that we can eat breakfast in the room, because as long as we can eat breakfast in the room, it's going to save us a bunch of money, because usually we only eat twice a day. We usually eat a late breakfast and then have an early supper and we're good to go. So I want to go to Walmart and I want to pick up a bunch of snacks, like bags of chips and boxes of cereal, drinks, things like that. So that way we're not having to go out to overpriced gas stations or going to vending machines when we want a snack, or even having to get in the car and go find an overpriced supermarket, I'm sure. I just want to have stuff available in the room. So if we get hungry, we can just kind of grab a bite of something to eat, and that's going to save us so much money. Also, I want to park the car when we get there and not get in it until it's time to leave. I don't want to get in that car for any reason. I don't want to have to, like, really, ideally, I don't want to have to get out of my pajamas unless it's to get into my bathing suit. Oh, and I'm so, so excited because the place that we booked has 2 pools, so I'm so, so freaking stoked. They also have like a sauna and a jacuzzi, so I cannot wait. And my husband, that was like his only caveat Anyway, he really, really wanted a hot tub, like a jacuzzi, because we're getting old. We're getting old. And he was like, I need a jacuzzi. I need a hot tub. So I was lucky enough. I lucked out enough to find a hotel that had everything that we all needed. So I'm stoked. They have this really pretty pool that Sean is super excited to be in. But that's really like, as long as you've got, there's even like a little like coffee house kind of restaurant on site as well. So ideally, we're not going to have to leave that, we're not going to have to leave the hotel grounds at all for anything. So I'm freaking stoked. And we're not staying super, super long, but even just a couple days is going to be enough for us to kind of like restart and like reboot a little bit. I cannot tell you how freaking excited I am. But because the booking ended up being so last minute, and it's really last minute, especially for us, it just means that we have a ton of stuff to do between now and then, now and when we leave. So we're just gonna have to like really get on it and really get stuff done. Also, I have to make arrangements for somebody to come by and feed the babies, feed the puppies, things like that. Speaking of puppies, freaking mama's pregnant again. I don't know what we're gonna do. I keep meaning to go get her spayed, and we actually found these diapers that she put on her, and we keep her in the cage when she's in heat because we just don't have the money to go get her spayed right now. So we found these like doggy diapers that she put on her when she's in heat, and we did that. We kept her in a cage. Somehow she freaking got pregnant again. So she's pregnant. She's going to have puppies here, I want to say, in the next probably month and a half. We're going to have a new litter of puppies. So be on the lookout for puppy content, because it's coming. And you know, the thing about puppies is they give me baby fever. Puppies give me baby fever literally every single time. And, you know, I end up falling in love with the little suckers, and then I end up just wanting to keep all of them. And like, that's just not feasible. It's not doable. I can't keep all of the puppies. So then I get emotionally attached. And then, you know, when I have to give them away, I get all sad. Anyway, so yeah, I have that to look forward to. But she's pregnant again. So yeah, we've got a lot of stuff to do before we go. I'm super freaking stoked though. As for this eye, y'all, how amazing is this eyeshadow? The way that they have kind of put this color story together makes it so completely effortless to do this kind of gradient eye, because all of the shades are just work so well together. It's actually kind of perfect. I am very, very in love with this. I do think that if you've never tried the Glam Light formula, be prepared to fall in love, because it will get you. You'll think, oh, it's just eyeshadow. How special, how spectacular can it be? It can be really, really spectacular, because this stuff is just absolutely phenomenal. Every time I use it, I am again just kind of baffled by how perfect and how easily and how seamlessly, look how seamless that gradient is. And usually even on a camera, the blend never shows up as pretty as it is in real life. And that blend is absolutely perfect. You just cannot beat the Glam Light eyeshadow formula, especially when it comes to the mattes. I think the shimmers are spectacular. They're really, really fabulous. They're super glittery and gorgeous. But when it comes to the mattes, I am a matte lover. As long as I have good mattes, I am good to go. I am super, super happy. And these really are just truly, truly special. I love them so, so much. I'm going to take just a little bit of this super light shimmer, put it up here right underneath my eyebrow. Speaking of like new makeup releases and drugstore releases, I'm really excited to be on a no buy, just because I think it is really important to love your own collection and love the things that you already have. And you know, I have more makeup, not a brag, definitely not a brag, but I have more makeup in my collection than, you know, that I could use in probably 10 lifetimes. So really, I could never buy another piece of makeup for my entire life and be just fine. But when you are like, when you have a YouTube channel and you're continuously like trying to make new content and things, I think the thing that I worry about the most is people getting bored of me using the same things over and over again. So, and also, I'm trying to blame it on that. I like buying new makeup. But I also think it is super important to enjoy your existing collection and enjoy the things that you already have. And just not to get super caught up in just consuming and purchasing and buying things like that. And even though, like, we're going to... even though we're going on vacation, I have no plans of going shopping. Like I said, I'm not buying a single stitch of makeup, but this kind of works out perfectly because, like I said, Sean has to go back to school really, really soon, just in the next couple of weeks, really. And because we're going out towards the outlets, it's going to be the perfect time for me to go ahead and get Sean his school clothes, things like that. And I swear, that boy grows so fast. None of the clothes that I purchased for him last year, or even none of the clothes that I purchased him for Christmas, still fits him. He has been doing nothing but growing for the last, I don't know, month and a half. And so it's so funny because when he puts his clothes on now, you can tell that they just don't fit. And not only has, like, he gotten bigger, my son is almost 14 years old and he wears a size. My towel is so dirty, but my son is 14. He wears a size 14 shoe. He is almost 6'1". He's just a freaking gentle giant. Ooh, is that? I don't know how I get eyeshadow everywhere, but it just happens. He's a gentle giant and he does nothing but grow. So even the clothes that I bought him for Christmas just a few months ago, they don't fit anymore. So it's going to be perfect. So I can just go ahead and pick him up a couple of staple pieces. You know, I only buy, like, this is what I do. So I'll go to, like, Old Navy, usually like Old Navy or Big and Tall, Big Dog, something like that. Ed Hardy. I think it's Ed Hardy. And I'll buy him a couple of really nice quality staple pieces. It's usually like a couple pair of really nice sweatpants, because that boy will wear sweatpants every day of the year and be extremely happy about it. He wears sweatpants and white t-shirts. So I usually buy him like a couple of really nice pairs of sweatpants. I'll buy him some socks and some underwear. And then everything else I will go to Walmart for. So like white t-shirts, just they get stained so quickly. A white t-shirt is going to last a maximum of like 5 uses before it's so stained that he's not going to be able to wear it to school anymore. And then it becomes at home clothes. So I usually just buy him a couple of packs of like Hanes white pocket t-shirts. And then, you know, just like socks and underwear, things like that. But it's literally all he wears. I tried last year, I tried to buy him a couple of pairs of like nice blue jeans, and they are still sitting in his closet with the tags on them, and they don't fit him anymore. So I end up having to take all of that and donate it, which is nice because somebody's getting really nice brand new jeans and I'm happy that I can help. But if I don't have to spend the money and waste the money, I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to work smarter, not harder this year. And I'm just going to go get him some really nice sweatpants, like sweatpants that are really going to last. And because he does wear them every single day, if I get him like cheapy sweatpants from like Walmart or something like that, the seams end up coming out, they end up getting holes in them, he ends up with holes in like in his thighs, like because he'll bend over or something. So I get nice, good quality sweatpants, and then I just get cheapy white t-shirts, just a pack of the Hanes stuff, and then I end up saving a good amount of money because I'm just going to end up having to do the same thing again in 6 months. So it ends up working out well. And then on top of that, when he outgrows everything, I don't feel like I'm throwing so much money away, but that kind of like, I usually end up giving it to my sister, and that kind of brings me into my next topic of conversation. So I don't know, did I talk about this already? I have no idea. My mind is going a million miles a minute, but my sister kind of barged right back into my life, and I was fully prepared to not speak to her ever again. Like, yeah, I mean ever again, but I was fully prepared to not speak to her for very, very long time. And I was actually having a really, really terrible morning. And I was just kind of sitting, drinking a cup of coffee, trying to watch a TV show, just trying to wake up a little bit. And I hear this like loud knock at the door. And I'm sitting here in my robe and Sean's still asleep, and my husband has just kind of left for work. And I thought, you know, honestly, from the way the knock sounded, I thought it was my husband. I thought he had forgotten something, or, you know, my husband is forever leaving his keys or his wallet, something like that at the house. So I thought it was just my husband coming back and forgetting something. So I answered the door, I'm in my robe, and I open the door, and there is this strange car, there's this strange vehicle in the driveway, but there's nobody standing at my door. So I'm looking around trying to figure out what in the world, what in tarnations is going on. And all of a sudden I hear a giggle from around the corner of my house. And there, lo and behold, is my sister popping her little face out from around the corner of my house. Just kind of like, here I am. And I'll just like, it is such a my sister kind of thing for her to do. She's insane. Like the last time we spoke to each other, we were like literally like going for each other's throat. You know how sisters can argue. We were literally like going for the jugular. And then for her to just kind of show up at my house out of nowhere, like completely and totally unexpected, to just show up at my house and knock on my door, it just kind of took me so far off guard that I didn't even think about not forgiving her. And you know, honestly, I was basically just waiting for her to reach out because I refused to do it this time. I refused to do it this time, but she reached out to me when she kind of realized that I was serious about it, because usually I'm the one that folds. I'll fold in a heartbeat. And though that's really not important in this situation, I'm just kind of like, I'm kind of flabbergasted that she decided to be the one to reach out, because like I said, it's usually me that does it. But she reached out and she was there, and she was like, is it okay that I'm here? She was like, do you want to see me? And of course I do. She's my little sister, you know. I was mad. I'm not gonna hate you for forever though. Like, you're my little sister. So she came in the house, and thankfully she had all of my nieces and nephew with her, so I got to see all of them. And when it comes to my sister, she is a special case of crazy, and not in a bad way, but she brings her own special brand of chaos. Like, chaos surrounds her. She's got three kids under 10. She is basically just kind of flying around like a chicken with her head cut off 99% of the time. Her life is just chaos. And then, you know, which is so different compared to my life, where everything is on a schedule, and I know exactly when something is happening, and I know exactly why something is happening, and nothing unexpected happens for me, and everything is very, very regimented. And my sister couldn't be further away from any of that if you paid her to be. Like, she's just the complete opposite of me. And again, you know, yin and yang, fire and ice, and we just kind of like balance out each other. And so she came in, and it was like we instantly picked up right where we left off. And it's not like she really gave me an apology, because, you know, we don't really do that. She didn't really apologize, but she did tell me that she was getting her life together. She was working out. She was working on things, and she had gone to the doctor and figured out everything that was going on with her and things like that. And there we, like, bipolar runs in our family like freaking crazy, so she just went to the doctor, she got everything figured out, and she's doing so much freaking better now. I am so incredibly proud of her. I am so proud of the way that she is handling things, of the way that she is just, she is doing so much better. And on top of that, she just looks so much happier. And I think that was one of the hardest parts about our relationship, because it was really hard for her to see me be happy when she was so miserable. And you know, I don't blame her for that at all, because it's difficult to watch somebody else succeed while you're basically at your rock bottom. It's really difficult to paste a smile on for somebody else when you're dying inside. And I think that the little break that we took really, really helped her to reevaluate everything that was going on for her, and for her to really take a step in the right direction. And boy, did she. She really just kind of stepped up and started taking care of herself, and really taking care of her like mental health, which is so freaking important. And she devotes herself to her children. and she puts herself on the back burner in every single situation. She is a fan, she's a fantastic mother. But she really just kind of, she puts all of her effort towards her children. And because there are three of them, that it just leaves nothing left over for her. And at the end of the day, she was just a husk of herself. And she just couldn't, she couldn't deal with it anymore. So I'm so happy, but she is doing so fantastic now. She has been like gardening, and she's a regular old farmer now. She grows corn and squash and zucchini, all kinds of stuff. She's just doing really, really well. So after that day where we kind of reconciled, we have literally talked at least twice a day on the phone every single day since then. And it's been really wonderful. I didn't realize how much I missed her. I didn't realize how much I missed that connection, because she's the only person in my family that I really talk to. My brother does his own thing and I really don't talk to him. And of course, you know, my dad, he passed not too long ago. I don't speak to my mother. That is one thing she's trying to get me to do. She's trying to get me to forgive my mom because she does talk to mom. And you know, I'm not going to, judge her. She is 100% allowed to do whatever it is that she wants to do. I just am not at a point in my life and in my journey yet where I feel like I can forgive my mother for the things that she's done. And so I'm just not there yet. She did say a couple times to me that she wants me to forgive mom, and she wants me to have a relationship with mom. I'm just not there yet. And that's okay. I don't have to be there yet. I'm not going to push myself where that is concerned. I'm not going to make myself have a relationship with someone I'm not ready to have a relationship with. That's going to do nothing but absolutely just kind of like halt any kind of progress, any kind of mental progress I've made in the last couple of months. It's going to completely like come to a grinding halt. I'm not going to do that. I'm just not going to do it. So, and I told her the same thing. I was like, when and if I'm ever ready to have a relationship with her again, then that's what I'll do. But until then, I just don't prefer if you didn't bring mom up. And she's fine. She actually, the day she came back into my life, ended up absconding with my son. And my son was like gung-ho for it. So it's not like she really kidnapped him, because he was a willing hostage. But she kidnapped him for a little bit and took him over to her house. And he went over and spent the night, which was super cute. I cannot tell you when the last time my husband and I had an evening to ourselves was. Again, I'm not really super close to my mom, and horror stories from my youth, things like that. I just never trusted anyone to have my child. So in the 14 years that he's been alive, I think he's spent the night away from me maybe like 5 times, including the time that he went with my sister a couple of days ago. So yeah, I don't let that boy go anywhere. And you know, that could be wrong on my part. Just don't trust other people, but I let him go with my sister. She basically just didn't give me a chance, but he went over with her, and they planted a little bit in the garden. He just had an absolute blast, and then she brought him home the next day. And my sister, I love my sister, but every time she comes to my house, she ends up coming into my office, and she will raid my stash. There is not a time that that woman comes over here that she doesn't leave with an absolute armful of whatever it is that she desires. Last time she was here, she left with a bunch of my skincare. She left with a couple of brush caddies, 2 bags full of clothes. Like, and that's my love language as well. I love to gift. I am a gifter from the word go. So yeah, she comes over here, and she's my younger sister, right? She's the kind of like the baby. So she's spoiled freaking rotten anyway. And she knows all she's got to do is ask, and I will freely give it to her. So yeah, and she milks it. She milks me for all I'm worth, but that's okay. But y'all, that's about it for today's video. I hope that you enjoyed today's video. I really enjoyed just kind of sitting here chatting with you guys for a little bit. This is what the eye look ended up turning out like. It is fantastico. I am very, very in love with it. It is very, very pretty. I'm gonna add a little bit of mascara, finish up my face, and I will, of course, post finished pictures over on Instagram and TikTok and Facebook, all that good stuff. All the links will be in the description box, along with all the products that I used in today's video. Guys, I love you so, so very much. As always, no filters, no edits, no fancy lighting. It's just me, sitting in front of my camera, playing with some makeup, hoping you guys are enjoying what I'm doing. And until next time, stay safe, take care of yourselves, and remember, you're important. Bye.